The stage is set for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s second State of the Nation address. Aside from government officials, Marcos's critics are also wrapping up preparations for their street activities alongside Monday's event. RG Cruz with a special report.
Representatives of various youth groups rode on the Barbie movie fad to bring to life their critique of the first year of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., days before he delivers his annual report to the nation. These educators gave the chief executive a failing grade.
Sabi namin, our first grading, sabi namin, maaaring nasa 75%. Pero ngayon, sa nakikita namin track, ay bagsak ang iginagrado namin sa kanya. Nananatili, no, kung bakit bagsak ang grado dahil hanggang ngayon, wala pa tayong nakikita ang hakbang kaugnay nung demand natin sa Magna Carta roadmap. Ito yung pinaka-crucial kasi dapat ang roadmap na ito i-reflect dito ang budgetary allocations ng DepEd. Pero sa last meeting na nailusad with them nung nakaraang araw, ay wala pa rin pong commitment para dito.
The Metro Manila Development Authority will deploy some 1,300 personnel to secure Commonwealth Avenue and the perimeter of the Batasan Pambansa complex. They'll do double duty because they're securing both the SONA and the planned transport strike. Emergency responders will also be deployed even as protesters have been given a set schedule and venue.
Insofar as SONA naman is concerned, from CHR to Tandang Sora lamang sila. I think hanggang alauna lamang po ng tanghali inalaw yung protesta. So hopefully maging maayos, hindi naman po natin hinaharangan yung karapatan ng ating mga kababayan na ipahayag yung kanilang saloobin. Pero sana isipin din po natin na meron din pong iba na maaring maabala.
Quezon Memorial Circle Management reminds protesters to do their activities outside the park to avoid disturbing park goers. They also have a long list of do's and don'ts, including the burning of effigies.
Magra-rally, magde-designate po tayo ng isang area na pwede silang mag-express po ng kanilang mga komento sa gobyerno po. Kinakausap naman po natin para nga hindi na maabala rin yung mga ibang one, mga park goers natin, kinakausap natin at nilalagay natin doon sa tamang pwesto po. Bawal din po yung pagsusunog dito kasi po park po ito. Kumbaga green space po ito. Bawal po siya kahit po kami, hindi kami pwedeng magsunog ng damo, hindi kami pwedeng magsunog ng dahon.
FPG, sir.
Mas lalo na po yun, bawal po yun, bawal po. Yung pagkakalat.
Walang pinag-usapang burning of FPG. Pero I will leave that to the law and order cluster kasi meron naman tayong mga law and order cluster na binuo kasama yung QCPD, kasama na yung DPOS, kasama na rin yung iba-iba pang mga members ito, yung task force disiplina, and I will leave that to their discretion kung I suppose it has to do with the amount of disruption that an activity will cause. Kung disrupt, they will have to act, no, contrary to or to act to maintain the peace. I will leave that to the discretion of the law enforcement.
Quezon City Hall also gave local police some 150 motorcycles to secure Monday's event. Even the Commission on Human Rights will be on alert as they hold on to the Philippine National Police's commitment to implement maximum tolerance towards protesters who will be exercising their rights. At the same time, the Commission reminded protesters they too have a responsibility to abide by the rules. Batasan Pambansa Complex, the seat of the House of Representatives, has been placed on lockdown as part of preparations to secure some 2,200 invited guests. Former Presidents Gloria Arroyo and Rodrigo Duterte have confirmed attendance, while former President Joseph Estrada may have difficulty attending due to health concerns. Former Vice President Lenny Robredo, whom the President defeated in the last election, declined. A prominent classical musician has been tapped to lead the singing of the national anthem.
Ang balita namin, there will be a singer, no, ng pambansang awit natin. Ang pangalan niya ay Lara Maige. Tinignan namin yun sa YouTube. Very famous pala siya.
Congressional leaders have already identified a welcoming committee who will greet the president, to be led by the Senate President Miguel Zubiri and Speaker Martin Romualdez. the dress code at the Sona Filipiniana and business attire.
Walang po yung gagamitin yung damit bilang protesta. May mga previous yun,
meron
na mga nakasulat sa suot nilang damit. Pinagbabawal po.
Before this, members of the progressive Makabayan Bloc showed media a glimpse of their statement outfits for the event. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Police conducts a walkthrough in Quezon City as part of security preparations for the President's Sona. Authorities went around 17 lines of defense, starting from Welcome Rotonda up to the Quezon City Police District Station 6. The PNP says over 22,000 personnel will be deployed for Monday's event. Tandang Sora Avenue, where thousands are expected to hold protests, will have a big line of defense, comprising of over 1,000 personnel. Four groups have been allowed to hold demonstrations.
Sa magrarally sa ating mga kasamahan, ano lang natin, maintain lang natin na maging peaceful ang ating pagrarally at yung napag-usapan sa coordinating conference ay dapat matupad. Maximum tolerance is we have a calibrated police response depende sa anong gagawin ng ating mga protesta.
In his first State of the Nation address, President Marcos vowed to confront issues hounding the health sector. But Filipino health workers assert they have not seen any changes in the country's health situation a year since Marcos took office. Willard Cheng with his special report.
More medicines have been added to the list of VAT-exempt health products intended for patients with cancer, diabetes, kidney disease, mental illness, tuberculosis, and hypertension. Benefiting patients like Amadeo, who spends an average of 200 pesos a week for his maintenance meds.
Malaki bagay po talaga sir sa akin yung pagmura. Kasi unang-una, hindi na ako kakapusi sa yung budget ko po.
In his first State of the Nation address, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vowed not to just make medicines more affordable, but to make healthcare services more accessible.
Beyond the issues that the pandemic has brought, the need for a stronger healthcare system is self-evident. We must bring services, medical services to the people and not wait for them to come to our hospitals and healthcare centers.
Construction for a multi-specialty medical center in Clark is set to begin, which is expected to house its own heart, kidney, cancer, and pediatric centers. The Department of Health says health workers are being recruited and trained to serve in the planned multi-specialty centers.
Ang pangangailangan sa mga serbisyong may kinalaman sa puso, sa lungs, sa kidney, ay hindi lamang para sa mga taga Metro Manila.
The administration intends to build more super health centers to address primary care needs of the poor. As specialty centers will be housed in public hospitals in the provinces. It took a while before the new government appointed a health secretary, but the focus remained on the fight against COVID and the recovery from the pandemic. Restrictions were lifted amid the pandemic, and the administration did not reimpose mask mandates despite an uptick in the number of COVID cases in the first half of the year. The government is currently studying the lifting of the country's public health emergency status.
Sapagkat binalansi po ng ating Pangulo at ng maraming namumuno sa iba't ibang sangay ng pamahalaan ang kalusugan at ang kabuhayan. Isipin nyo na lamang po kung nagpatuloy pa po ang mga restriction, baka hindi na tayo makabangon.
The DOH has started to roll out bivalent vaccines for healthcare workers and senior citizens. It targets to finish the first batch of 390,000 doses of Pfizer bivalent vaccines donated by Lithuania and expects to receive more from the COVAX facility. But data from the DOH show only 48,000 of the eligible population have been inoculated with a bivalent shot as of July 14.
One of the cornerstones of a strong healthcare system is the provision of competent and efficient medical professionals. We will exert all efforts to improve the welfare of our doctors, our nurses, and other medical frontliners.
Meanwhile, the Alliance of Health Workers sees no change in the welfare of medical frontliners, saying issues such as low wages, benefits, understaffing, and contractualization in hospitals remain.
Hindi namin ramdam ito dahil parang walang pagbabago pa rin. Kasi kung dali kaya, ito yung ating major na panawagan talaga, itigil ang contractualization sa hanay ng mga health workers, magkaroon ng mass hiring para matugunan yung chronic understaffing. At number one, yung ano talaga, itaas ang sahod, yung nakabubuhay na sahod, family living wage. Ang panawagan namin ay dapat yung entry salary for the salary graduate is 33,000 and then both public and private nurses, ang entry salary ay dapat nasa 50,000.
Health Secretary Teodoro Herbosa says he is ready to listen to issues raised by healthcare workers.
Pag-isipin mo yung healthcare workers, umaalis ang healthcare workers natin. Eh. So we're not able to pay them the pay scale that they can get abroad. So very important, but we'll really take care of them. And it's very important we listen to them. Pakinggan natin sila and make sure we're able to address the complaints that they have.
The issue of pay for government workers is now up to Congress, he says, while efforts are being undertaken to pay for the arrears.
Of course, that's legislation. No? Sana isama yon. Yung arrears, of course, naka-budget na yon sa ating national expenditure. At ngayon, inuutos ko na nga na i-release na yung mga for 2023 na arrears pa.
Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
The education sector also laying out its demands for President Marcos ahead of his SONA. A teachers group urges the president to raise their entry-level salary to 50,000 pesos. Alliance of Concerned Teachers Chair Vladimir Quetua says granting a salary hike is just a matter of political will. Non-teaching personnel also urging the government to triple their entry-level salaries to 33,000 pesos.
Matatandaan natin na ngayong panahon ito, taong ito ay huling taon na ng SSL5, no? Pero tuloy-tuloy ang pagtaas at sirit ng presyo ng bilihin, no? Yung buwis ay tuloy-tuloy. Kaya yung panawagan ng pagtaas ng sahod o nakabubuhay na sahod, no? Ay kailangan talagang itulak ito lalo pa sa panahon ito.
A labor leader also calling on the president to address low wages and continued contractualization.
May mga proposal kami sa kanya na meron man nakahain na 150 pesos across the board wage increase sa Kongreso, both houses of Congress, ba pwedeng itulak 'yan para magkaroon ng remedial measures.
Coconut farmers hoping to hear measures to improve the industry during the president's SONA. 64-year-old farmer Ernesto decried the cheap price of his produce, which is only valued at 5 pesos apiece. He says that's clearly not enough to cover his workers' daily wage of 350 pesos and buy basic commodities. Uplifting the coconut industry will allow farmers to escape poverty. He now calls on Marcos to heed the farmers' demands during his SONA on Monday. Transportation Department says the Metro Manila subway project is now over 30% complete. Let's get more details on that story from Katrina Domingo. Kat, good afternoon. What do you have for us?
Rica, a third of the multi-billion peso Metro Manila subway has been completed, with much of the accomplishment coming from the design and procurement of equipment. That's according to Department of Transportation Undersecretary for Railways Cesar Chavez. Chavez told reporters in a press conference that while the design and procurement is almost complete, actual construction of the subway is only at 5.6%. He says so far, construction is just ongoing between the stations in Valenzuela and North Avenue. That's 4 stations, and he expects that by Christmas, Valenzuela all the way down to Quirino will have been completed. He says that like other government construction projects, right-of-way remains to be an issue in several areas, noting that some homeowners from an upscale village in Quezon City has raised concerns over how the project could possibly affect their residences. He says that these residents have fear that their residences might crumble or might be affected if the tunnel will be dug underneath their homes. But the DOTR says that they shouldn't worry because studies, especially from Japan, show that the building of subways would actually reinforce their homes, as it would show that there are no sinkholes in the area and that the equipment that would be placed underground would actually reinforce the land around that area. Chavez also says that the DOTR is in the process of actually pushing through with this project despite qualms from several homeowners. You also have the Department of Justice saying that the government is expected to have its way, especially if the area would be used for public services, because the power of eminent domain will always be greater than a private right. Rica, the Metro Manila subway, dubbed by the government as the project of the century, is expected to have 17 stations in the capital region. It is also expected to reduce travel time between Valenzuela City and Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 3 to 41 minutes from the current 1 hour and 10 minutes. Rica.
All right, thank you so much, Katrina Domingo, reporting live. The Philippines is done with the International Criminal Court. That statement coming from President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. after the ICC rejected Manila's plea to stop the resumption of its probe into the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. Marcos says, with no appeals pending, the government's dealings with the International Tribunal have come to an end.
We continue to defend the sovereignty of the Philippines and continue to question the jurisdiction of the ICC and their investigations here in the Philippines. They are talking about Filipinos. Their alleged crimes are here in the Philippines. The victims are Filipino. Bakit napupunta sa Dehig? Basta tapos na lahat ng ating pag-uusap sa ICC. At kagaya ng sinasabi ni namin mula sa simula, we will not cooperate with them in any way, shape or form.
State prosecutors reaffirmed their earlier ruling that cleared 17 policemen of murder charges over their involvement in one of the so-called Bloody Sunday operations. The Justice Department junked the motion for reconsideration filed by the mother of Chay Evangelista, who died along with her husband during the raid in Batangas last year. The prosecutor said it found no probable cause to charge the cops. It added the bullets found in the victims' bodies did not match the firearms issued to the police. Human rights groups slammed the ruling. Defend Southern Tagalog says the DOJ has abandoned its mandate to side with fairness and truth. For rights group Karapatan, the dismissal of the murder raps shows the Marcos administration's contempt for justice. It adds, this only shows the skewed justice system in the Philippines. The weather system we are monitoring, Egay, has intensified into a tropical storm. Let's get more details on how this will affect weather conditions in the country from our Pagasa weather forecaster, Rhea Torres. Ms. Rhea.
As of the moment, the center of tropical storm Egay was estimated based on all available data at 750 kilometers east of Viracatan, Tanduanes. Said tropical storm has maximum sustained winds of up to 65 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 80 kilometers per hour, and is currently moving westward slowly. Said a tropical storm is still far from the Philippine landmass, therefore we currently have no tropical cyclone wind signal raised over any parts of the country. However, it will be bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms, or the trough of Tropical Storm Egay will be bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Caraga and Eastern Visayas. Meanwhile, due to the effects of the southwest monsoon, Western Visayas, Palawan, and Occidental Mindoro will also be expecting rainy weather for the next 24 hours. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, generally fair weather conditions will still persist, although there are still chances of isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, usually by the afternoon or the evening. And for the state of our coastal waters, no gale warning is still raised over any seaboards of our country. However, on Sunday, Egay may bring moderate to rough seas over the eastern seaboards of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And we are also expecting the enhanced southwest monsoon during this weekend or coming weekend until Monday to be bringing occasional rains over western Visayas, occidental Mindoro, and the northern portion of Palawan, including Calamian Islands. Meanwhile, for Metro Manila area or large portions of Luzon as well as Mindanao, fair weather conditions may still persist over this coming Sunday until Monday. However, there are still chances of thunderstorms around the afternoon or the evening. The full effects of this enhanced southwest monsoon may be felt starting this coming Tuesday and for the rest of the week. And that is the latest here from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Ms. Rhea, just a question, please. On Monday, the second State of the Nation address by the President will be happening. How is the weather going to be for Metro Manila?
Yes, well, for Metro Manila area, generally fair weather conditions may still be persisting. However, there are still chances of light to moderate rains. We are also expecting thunderstorms around the afternoon or the evening.
All right. Thank you so much. With that, I'll let you go, Ms. Rhea Torres, our Pagasa weather forecaster.